Hi everyone, this is a quick video on what has changed in the process chart or process matrix table in the sixth edition, that was in the sixth edition, or in the process groups, a practice standard book, and the version that is now available in the eighth edition. So what is the changes? So this is the earlier version of the process matrix tables, where there were 10 knowledge areas, 49 processes, and 5 process groups. Let me bring the latest edition from the PMBOK 8th edition. So now, if you see at the first look, there are no knowledge areas now. So this is now named to performance domains. And process group is now focus areas. Earlier, there are 5 process groups, initiating process group, planning process group, and so on. Now, these are replaced with initiating focus area, planning focus area, executing focus area, and so on. So earlier there were 5 process groups. Now in PMBOK 8th edition, there are 5 focus areas. And if you see that 10 knowledge areas, now it has become 5 performance domain. So those who did not know what is the difference between knowledge areas and performance domain, the basic difference between knowledge area and performance domain is, earlier, the knowledge areas are focused on outputs, but performance domains are more focused on outcomes. So if you see, earlier there are 10 knowledge areas, now there are 7 performance domains. So communication is not here. Rather, communication and stakeholder is merged with stakeholder performance domain. And there is no quality. There is no quality knowledge area. All right, it is removed. Because why PMA removed? Because PMA is considering that quality is an attribute of score. So the quality is now integrated with score, especially the control quality and plan quality part. And if you see, there is no procurement knowledge area or performance domain here. This is not here. Procurement is in a separate appendix in 8th edition, that is appendix X4, where you will get the detail of the procurement. Now let's talk about what are other changes. So there are a lot of wording changes in the performance domain names and also in the process names. So earlier, this integration management is a key knowledge area which actually combined, unified all other processes. So this integration is now named as governance. I believe this is a very good shift. So it is talking about the whole governance of the project management mechanics, project management processes. And you see, the cost management is now named as finance. This is also a good change. All right. So this is the major changes in the knowledge areas and performance domains, and also the namings or wordings. And if you see, now let's talk about the processes. What are the changes happened in the processes? So there are earlier 49 processes. Now there are 40 processes. So where are those 9 processes? So if you see in integration, there are earlier 7 processes, but now there are total 9 processes. Okay. And the quality is not here in the new version, the quality performance domain, but the managed quality assurance is in governance now. Earlier, this quality assurance was managed quality, and that was also in execution. So it is also now in executive focus area, and it is actually focusing on the process part of the quality, mainly focusing on the process part of the quality. And if you see, there is no procurement performance domain, but planned procurement The plan procurement is now named as plan sourcing strategy. Okay, so actually quality is not fully removed. So the main process is already in the executing focus area, and procurement also is not removed. It is already in the planning part. The plan sourcing strategy is the part of focus planning focus area. And now let's talk about what happened to the communication knowledge area and those three processes. So earlier in the communication knowledge area, there are three processes. And in the stakeholder, there are four processes. These four processes. So now these seven processes are merged together in this stakeholder performance domain. All right. So what happened with the nine other, what happened to the rest of the nine processes? Because here is 49, here is 40. So some processes are merged. For example, earlier in schedule chapter, there are total five processes. But now in the schedule, especially in the planning focus area, there are two processes. What happened? Define activities, sequence activities, estimate activity durations, all are now merged with develop schedule. So three processes are reduced here. And if you see the RICS chapter, RICS process, RICS knowledge area, so there were earlier five processes, and these two processes, which are related to RICS analysis, perform qualitative RICS analysis and perform quantitative RICS analysis, these two now merge with this one, perform RICS analysis. So it is covering both the processes. So 3 plus 2, 5. Another two process from the procurement that I already mentioned, the procurement performance domain is not here. Only one process is here, which was earlier named as plan procurement. That is now plan sourcing strategy. And other two are moved to the appendix X2 of PMBOK 8th edition. So seven processes are here. And the quality, that the two processes, especially the plan quality and control quality process, those two are not here. So as I mentioned, those two were merged with scope. And another change, the wording change of the process names. Now the process names are more simpler, more generic in nature. If I show you, if you see earlier, the develop project charter, earlier the name was develop project charter of this process. Now the name is now changed to very generic and simple name, that is initiating project or phase. Earlier the name was quite technical, develop project management plan. Now it is saying integrate and align project plans. All right. So direct and manage project work. Now it is manage project execution. So similarly, if you see, there are some changes in the naming convention. So now these are now more generic and more understandable. So these are the major changes happened in the process group matrix table that was earlier in the 6th edition, and the new process chart that is available in the PMBOK 8th edition. Thank you for staying with me. Bye.